Please call out your name.
I would just like to ask, other than the IMS material that they provide us here, what books did you follow for all the subjects?
You have to be perfect with it, but remember that people say that only repeats are important. But this year only 20 repeats came, 20-25. So you should be thorough with the repeat, because even one repeat mistake will cost you around 800 times. So repeat should be perfect. For I think the regular books, the textbook which you use during all the 5 hours at BBS are very important in studying. I would prefer that alongside the IMS notes, keep a reference textbook, standard textbook. Like for biochemistry, Harper. For physiology, Genom is very good. I would ask you to read Genom, it's very important. Then NET, Chaurasia, you can just refer if you have any difficulty. Then Micro, I read Arvind Arora for MCQs. And Anand Narayan, if any difficulties are there. Then Petho, Robbins. Be very thorough with Robbins. If Petho you know properly, then it helps you in medicine. So pathophysiology will help you in clinical symptoms and will help you in answering all medicine questions. Even if you don't know the detail of any medicine question, you can answer based on patho and physio. Then pharmac, Sparsh Gupta was good. Then I also read Tripathi, just a little bit. And Katzam is very good. I prefer Katzam. IMS pharmac also, the new drugs are being put on.
No thanks.
Then forensic, I think IMS notes are very good. Maybe across you can read if you want, but I think I. Then oftan, usually actually we neglected thinking only 5-6 questions will come, but this year around 20-25 questions came to our surprise. But I think oftan, if you know across is, you can refer. I think you should know the basic. Often questions are mainly, some questions are very tough, which I think all India, I think only 2-3 people will answer. That was a well luck. And otherwise, the questions which are based on basics, like your glaucoma and all those, retinoblastoma, all those things, that you can read from Parson. Even that, this for AIMS, November, some Oguchi's disease had come. That was given in Parson actually. So then ENT, I think the your books are very good, and Dingra is, I refer Dingra also. PSM Path, I refer Path, most of the topics of Path.
Wow, that's fantastic. Hope you've written down everything. I just like to just enlighten us on the Harrison tables.
Harrison tables are concerned, be selective in reading Harrison tables. Don't read everything, okay? Harrison tables, you go with connective tissue disorders. There is a list giving what are the conditions to be fulfilled to make a diagnosis, for example, rheumatoid arthritis. For that matter, whichever connective tissue disorder is there. And be updated with the latest edition of Harrison tables. That is one thing. And second thing is genetics. Genetics is one part where you can score where others don't score. Be very clear with genetics, okay? That is genetics part. And more about, I will talk about Harrison in general. For when you're reading microbiology, read pathogenesis part in Harrison, that's enough. Don't read all of the infections, okay? Pathogenesis part in Harrison is important. When you read microbiology, you just read pathogenesis, you'll understand what is the nature of that organism, how it acts in the body. Okay, when you understand this concept, you will know which antibiotics you can use for that, which is the drug of choice for that organism. So this is how you integrate three important subjects: medicine, infections, microbiology, and pharmacology, antibiotics. This is how you integrate subjects, right? This is one thing. And actually, to be very frank, I tried to read Harrison tables. There is a Xerox giving only Harrison tables, but I couldn't, it was beyond my reach actually, to be very frank. But then I told you, connective tissue disorders and whichever new topics are there, upcoming topics, important topics in PG exams like infections, okay. And the other thing is respiratory medicine. Tables in respiratory medicine are very important, okay. So you should read those things, cutoffs for whatever it is. All those respiratory system in Harrison tables, you'll be perfect. Connective tissue disorders, that's enough, I think. I don't think reading everything, wasting your time, it's actually not required.
Thank you, Doctor. Well, I would like to come to Dr. Pushpa, and I would want to know, in terms of the FTS, like we all know, yes, it simulates the entire environment of your All India tests, but you know, there are a lot of people in the very first, you know, 5 or 7 tests would kind of get a little more demotivated because it is difficult. It is only 3 hours. How do you, you know, just give them, you know, a kind of tell them that how do you really, you know, deal with that stress? And just in case if you're making mistakes, do you really, is it very important to go back and immediately look out for the right answers and just not leave it for tomorrow? So do you need to do that? Did you do that? How did you deal with it?
One thing I want to tell is, like, I just tell you how wide it was. I used to write also Bhartiya test and IMS also. When I started, my ranking was around 4,000. And the last test, I scored 20. So this will be a gradation where you will, it's not like you just write one test and you know everything. Or you write one test and you don't know anything. It's just like, either you should target, like, as he said, you should have a timetable. It could be along with your subject wise, like according to IAMS subject classes or something. Or you set your own timetable where you give preference to your timetable. But this should be just an add-on in your timetable. Don't concentrate on two things at the same time. You should just balance between the two things. Actually, in this time all India, time management was the most important because
so do you think the IMS FTS really prepares you for that time management like you just talked about?
That's the thing that I'm coming to, both Bhartiya and IMS actually. IMS, like, questions are much more bigger and, like, the answers are also tough. This time already was almost answering 400 to 420 questions in 300, like, it was clubbed like that. So, basically, time management is more important. It's not that you don't know, that's why you don't answer. You know, but you don't answer, that actually makes you feel very bad. So writing these tests, you will learn where you are going wrong, where you went wrong, and how can you correct. The methodology, learning the methodology is more important through these tests rather than getting the answers. So I want you to people write the more and more number of tests and learn the methodology right so that you will be the best in all exams.
And how about the, you know, the preparations in terms of the question papers? Should it be 5 years, 7 years, or how do we need to go about it? I'm sure most of you would want to know that, right?
It's 5 years or 7 years, matter of how you concentrate and read the concept. Only the concept is important. Repeats will come, but repeats are hardly 20 to 30 of the last time. Only in, many people I think are from Andhra. Andhra this year is only the repeats. Last year only the paper was toughest exam, what you say. This year only there was all repeats were there. So concentrate on concept and read the pathology, main, as our friends wrote, pathology and gram and data. These two are very, very important. I have read only these two books, pathology, Robbins, and all the short subjects are very good for IMS. IMS materials, anesthesia, of the ENT. ENT sir will dictate the notes. He will tell you, you should complete that notes in 6 hours, last hour in there before going. You will definitely complete it. Trust me, one question will never cross from the ENT notes. Only 6 hours. Hardly some 30 to 40 pages you will write in this 1.5 day, today and tomorrow. You will definitely try.
Thank you. What were you really doing